Good morning from the US. I don't know what's going on with my hair today. I didn't feel like doing it, so I put it up, and then these front pieces bother me and I don't know what to do. What's up, guys? I feel like I'm back home. It's been so long. If you're not caught up, I have been bopping around for the past like almost 3 weeks. I went to Miami for my college roommate Brooke's bachelorette weekend. There's a vlog from that. I went to New York for like two, three days for a really fun trip with NBC where I met Jimmy Fallon, and just like tons of really cool things went on there. And now you guys have seen this. I presently have not edited this yet, but then I went to Paris with the makeup company Artistry Studio. That was such an amazing trip. So I guess you guys have already seen that vlog currently. That's on my to-do list to edit that. But right now it is Tuesday and I'm in LA. I've never been so happy for warmth and sun and palm trees and just, you know, to not be on an aircraft. I got back a couple days ago and I've just been taking this time to sleep. And now I need to like get my life together and, you know, buy groceries and things like that. So many fun things have happened lately. Right now I'm about to go to, oh, I forgot my rings. Do you guys feel naked when you like realize you forgot the piece of jewelry you wear every day? I'm currently about to go to Alfred's really quickly to get some coffee. I got my nails done right before Paris. Somebody I've never had do them before did them, and I thought he did a great job. I really enjoyed the experience during it. They have been like peeling up on the edges. I don't know if you can see. Flicking off. Okay, like multiple of them are like that, and my nail place has a 10-day gel guarantee, and today's the 9th day, so I might go in there just to get like these couple fixed. So I thought I'd bring you guys along. Also, I was gonna play you a song to kick this off in the car because I just feel like that's fun to do, but YouTube now, you get copyrighted off literally 1 second of a song and then you can't monetize the video. So I've been getting requests for drive with me videos because I haven't posted one of those in a while. And that's the reason that I haven't posted them, is because you used to be able to put up to 30 seconds of a song and you were fine, and now it's like literally 1 second you will get copyrighted. So it's rather unfortunate, you know, because then it's like you can't make any money. I understand that artists get ripped off often, and I fully agree that they should get a portion of the ad revenue, but for them to make all of the ad revenue, or like the labels, or I don't know what amount even trickles back down to the actual singer, but for them to get all of the revenue from a video that someone else put all of the creative work into that they wouldn't be profiting otherwise from. Are you guys with me? What is your opinion? Let me know. I just feel like it's not fair for them to take all of it. We're gonna go. Can we just laugh that I just turned on my vlog camera to be this close up? I got my two nails fixed. They were great. Really interesting thing was going on where I asked for black, and then I've gone the past like 8 days thinking my nails were black, and then I happened to glance down in the sun and realized they were navy, like seemingly, or just like slightly, not even like a true blue navy, but like they were not black. So in there with the girl just now, we spent so long trying to find this like mysterious color that is in their salon, and we just could not figure it out. So finally I was like, just put black on the two, because like it looks like black unless you're like in direct sunlight. So we did that. I got my little vanilla latte from this little bakery, so support local businesses. I also didn't realize they have macaroons and like all kinds of basically everything that I buy from Whole Foods for when I like host stuff. So I'm gonna start going there because the prices were a little bit better, and they're just really nice there. This latte, loving it. Do you guys see this kind of ice? It's like that crushed ice. If you live in the greater triangle area, I highly recommend going to Parker and Otis in Durham. They use this kind of ice, so it reminded me of that. And you have to get iced coffee with coconut flavor in it, which sounds really weird, but that's probably my favorite iced coffee ever, is their coconut iced coffee. Or Bean Traders with hazelnut, but I think Parker and Otis takes the cake. All right, I need to go. I've got to get out of the house. So at this cute fridge from a company called New Air, and we just have it in this room because we had all this space and we wanted to have a place to put some cute drinks. So I'm gonna open this so there's not a glare. Here's what we got going on. It looked super cute, then we neglected it for a while. So while I'm at Target, since I'm only buying a couple things, I'm gonna pick up some more things to make this look full, and then I'm gonna come back and make it look all pretty. But I'm gonna have this fridge linked below. So as you can tell, we're having some work done on our roof. I forgot to finish vlogging the other day. I feel like this is exactly where we dropped that off. So I just can't stand to be there anymore. So right now I'm about to go to Target. Progress update. This looks so much cuter the first time I did it because I had like 4 different kinds of LaCroix. And it was really like a creative outlet. It still kind of is, but right now we have a bunch of like different drinks and whatnot.
So we're just organizing them in here. This first thing was super convenient because you can remove these shelves and they have ones that are even like half length. So if you wanted, you could have like, let's say this one's a half length. So you have like cans here and cans here, but then this side you have like something tall because like there's not that divider. Yeah, it was a great addition to our home.
Happy hour with Shell Bay.
The happiest hour.
The happiest hour.
I'm so happy.
We spent $10 on this. It's amazing.
Now the heater's on.
Yeah.
It's my Friday routine, getting an acai bowl. What's up, guys? It's Friday. I don't think I've vlogged since like the past Friday, except for maybe a couple clips. Outfit of the day. Little urban tee, my new bag that I carry every day from Express, and just some Topshop jeans. So we just got this new rug in here. Tell us what you think of it. Ignore the weights there. That was because the corners were like rolling up. Mixed feelings. It's kind of hard because we got a stupid table that had a print on it. So now it's like always going to be a print on top of a print, but I kind of like the dark contrast going on. We have a light rug in here and it's already difficult enough to like keep that clean. So we definitely, we're not going to do a light rug in this room because people eat there.
I'm watching Cimarelli's new video because A, the song's a banger. All of her songs are.
You say I am loved.
Lisa is so good.
When I talk
alone. I've been a Cimarelli fan since like a couple years before I started making videos, and I was obsessed with them. I remember I messaged Christina, I think, and asked for advice or for video requests, or I don't really know, but she requested a makeup for green eyes tutorial, and you can go find it, and it's terrible. It's like purple eyeshadow. And she also told me I needed to smile more and that people comment that, or used to comment that, I guess, on her videos and tell her that. And she's like, I know, it's hard to think about. You should smile more. I don't still think about that.
Shelby just bought.
Oh, I can't sing also.
Can you go inside? Oh.
What's the easiest song ever to sing?
Like,
what you?
Alright, this is overexposed, but we're.
Yeah, it's probably this part.
I'm fist fight. Oh, nope, not even. You know. Do you know the song?
Yeah.
Shelby.
Easy karaoke.
As you can tell,
song.
Right as we were leaving to go meet up with Casey for a little, like, lunch dinner, it's like 3 o'clock. She was getting delivered an Amazon package that was this karaoke mic. So. We've just set it all up and are gonna, I mean, when I listen
it
to the radio,
it was super easy, it just worked. We didn't have
Shelby
to charge
Church
it.
Talent.
Get ready.
I'm gonna drive and you just take it away.
It's Shelby! Hey! It's a little you ain't.
It hasn't started yet.
Oh, have fun bleeping this out. This is super embarrassing. You can't put this on YouTube.
We are in the
parking garage
doing karaoke. Now we're pretty much done. What song?
Seven things.
My throat hurts.
1, 2, 3, 4.
This is so fast.
I wasn't ready.
But at times I get so scared when I think about the previous relationship we've shared. You make me laugh, you make me cry, I don't know which side to buy. Your friends and jerks when you act like them, just gonna win her. You make me love you.
Alright, well I think we have exhausted that.
Just keep pushing, someone's gonna be another
day. I'm done.
Didn't make the shot, but that's the drill. This is a drill of coach.
No! This Duke game beat them. Duke always finds a way to win at the last second. They have to lose. Good morning, people. It is Monday, April 1st. Oh, it's April Fool's Day. I need to figure out a prank to pull on Adrian.
I know I haven't put up a vlog since Paris, whenever you're seeing this, so that's my B. I was gonna have a video up before my friend came in town. One of my college roommates, Kalia from college, visited from Wednesday morning through late last night, so Sunday night. And I didn't get the video up in time, so she left. I have one day here, and then tomorrow I go to Nashville, so I'm gonna vlog there as well, and I just thought I would take you guys with me through today. So, I showered, got ready. Currently, I'm laying out a few things to go ahead and start packing for Nashville. First of all, okay, I'm a cup hoarder. I need to take those downstairs, but let's take in the fact that my room, this is stuff I've laid out to pack, is quite clean. I need to organize a few things on my desk. But I'm impressed. As always, have a nice neutral palette laid out. I've been re-wearing a lot of the same items lately, but it's all good. So we're gonna see this dress for the 50th time. And I'm trying to figure out what the weather's gonna be like there because the lows are in the 40s, or at least one night. Me and Shelby leave tomorrow morning pretty early and are meeting up with our other roommate, Mallory, who has been on tour for a few weeks and concludes in Nashville. So we're gonna go stay with her there because she moved here from there and she still has a place. So taking advantage of having a free place to stay. So we stay there through Friday and then we come back and then we have a weekend of birthday celebrations. It is Shelby's roommate Lauren's birthday on Friday, so we're doing stuff that night. Mallory's birthday is on Saturday, so we're doing stuff Saturday. And I think Sunday we're doing a brunch for Lauren as well, like a bigger thing. So anyways, lots going on. I'm gonna pack up a few things, trying to figure out what to wear. And we're also redoing our closet room, which I'm gonna give you a preview of the before. So this side, the actual clothing storage side, that's mine, is staying the same. I need to clear out the rest of the stuff. This has just been like a hoarding room and it's not functional. So Adrian and I are gonna add a little double desk situation and we have some cool art stuff that's gonna go up on this wall. So I also bought a couple things at Topshop yesterday. Got a new pair of jeans, just plain black ones, because my other ones from there had honestly just like stretched out over time. So since I knew that they stretched out over time, they were like way too big in the waist and like wore every single time I wore them, but I just like dealt with it because they were a good length and whatever. So I went down a size. That way when they stretch out, we won't have that issue. And then I just got this little top. Especially thought this would be cute for my Israel trip. Or even Nashville. I don't know, a little like cropped tie thing. And then I just got a little cropped white t-shirt because even though it's a little bit ridiculous and unnecessary to get t-shirts from Topshop, I really like the ones they have there. It's just like, I think they do have really good basics that aren't ridiculously overpriced. So this is just like a little cropped length tee, which would be cute with a lot of like fun pants I have. That's that. Also, we went to Melrose Trading Post yesterday, me and Kalia. You saw my favorites video on my main channel, my most recent one. I talked about these candles that are made locally from a place called Lit Candle Supply. And they set up at Melrose Trading Post. And I just bought this one that says, it's better in LA and it smells really good. So here's today's OOTD, just wearing a basic t-shirt with jeans I just got, booties. I believe it's 81 degrees out, so I'm probably gonna be warm. Got some little hoops, wearing different glasses. I also realized yesterday that I need to stop wearing sunglasses in every single Instagram photo I take because it's every photo.
Oh, this is gonna be key. Yeah!
Here's the next one, preview. Oh, Adrian doesn't even know what's next. Yes. We are on a roll.
They call the time lapse a time loop. The time loops.
Riddle me this. How is this so far over and then over there it becomes like that much? Look at us go.
Who decided to call thumbs opposable?
Because I do not know.
Because what are they opposing? They're not opposing each other.
They're opposing.
They're not even opposing.
No, they oppose our fingers. If we just had a thumb going straight out, we couldn't. Like, we can't grab as easily with these two.
Why don't
fingers?
We call that, like, a differential thumb?
I don't know. Maybe you could take that up with the board of scientists.
It's not opposing. Like, there's some hostility.
It is opposing. No, but look, it's opposing these fingers.
But, like, there's.
There's
such a just different connotation to opposing it.
I agree.
That implies active conflict.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Totally. Your thumbs aren't opposing each other, they're opposing the rest of your fingers.
But like not actively.
Because other animals don't have that.
Yes, are they literally opposite? Sure. But are they actively opposing? No, they're coexisting.
They're coexisting.
Calling up the board of thumbs.
The board of thumbs.
Also known as the hand. incredible.
I cannot. I need to pee.
Okay.
Oh,
too late. Putty's on it.
Oh, I think I sense something. I might have mistakenly done.
These are supposed to be like here.
No.
Okay.
Oh, maybe. I think I might have pulled a couple from this, or if we had an extra out.
Okay, well, this was for sure over here, but on the bottom row.
Okay.
Just say my